Hello, brave, beautiful, beloved soul friends. Welcome to another Conversations with Kristen, that beautiful time of your day where you explore human consciousness from the inside out. So in the past few years, I have been exploring my brain's neural networks from the inside out, investing thousands of hours in self-hypnosis and then thousands more hours in neuroscience research and slowly connecting the dots to understand human consciousness from the inside out. And I've discovered some pretty radically revolutionary, incredibly awesome, epic, deeply helpful insights that I'm stoked to be sharing with you, starting today and continuing over the next year or two. It's a lot, so I'll be dripping things down slowly but surely. So today I want to talk about activation of attachment systems and what that means, what that looks like, how we can recognize it, how we can respond to it. So attachment systems are at the baseline of our subconscious realms, and it's what connects our unconscious mind and our unconscious body, or our subconscious realms and our unconscious states. And you can find out more about this in my Pyramid of Personhood and one piece of my Liberated Consciousness Diagram, and I have these available for free on my website. You can download a book called Loving Liberation, and it talks a little bit about this and how attachment systems are at the core of everything. They're what shape the regulatory states and the integrative states of unconscious states. So there's all these things going on in our body. We've got like our left brain hemisphere talking with our right brain hemisphere. We've got our forebrain talking with our hindbrain. We've got our nervous system regulating. We've got our brain waves regulating. We've got our cranial nerves functioning. We've got all this stuff going on in our unconscious body. Attachment systems are what determine how those things are programmed. And attachment systems connect our unconscious mind and body. So our subconscious realms that create our sense of identity and store information about who we are and what we've experienced connect with our unconscious body and all the regulatory stuff in this, like the pace at which my heart beats, through attachment systems. And then everything that develops in subconscious realms stems from attachment systems. And so we've got all these subconscious timelines. We've got meaning-making associations and memories and this and that and all of these neural networks that create our thought forms. All of our thought forms are created through activations of subconscious realm aspects. And all of them stem from attachment systems. And so attachment systems are really, really important. They are the thing that makes everything what it is within the human experience, because human experience comes from inside of us. Human experience doesn't come from out there. That's just activational stimulus. Human experience comes from inside of our neurobiological applications of consciousness. Okay, so attachment systems are really super important, and you can download that free book at kristenwindsor.com/freebies. There's also the link in the video description, and there's a bunch of goodies on there. Loving Liberation is the one that talks about attachment systems specifically, but there's several books, so feel free to grab them all. Gifts from my heart to yours, because I want you to succeed. I want you to have the tools to embody happiness, not just pursue it. I want you to have the tools to transform your life experience from the inside out, because you do have the power to do that. You are not powerless in this life. No matter what life has taught you, you have power to transform your experience. No matter what life has taught you, you have power to transform your identity. No matter what life has taught you, you have power here and now to reclaim authority within the unfolding storybook of your life. The power is already yours. You just have to choose to harness it. That's it. It's right here for the taking. It's right here. And so I've got several books. Brain Rewiring Playbook teaches you how to rewire your brain in some pretty simplified steps with encouraging tips, tricks, and tools. And there's a bunch of other goodies. So feel free to check out kristenwindsor.com/freebies for some super epic healing journey magic. Okay. So we've got attachment systems. They're super important. They're managing like all the stuff that makes us and propels us through experience. Because our conscious awareness, that just observes in response to experience. All the actual experiences going on in our unconscious mind and body. Okay, so got the basics out of the way. Another little quick basic is we are consciousness, not neurobiology. It's the person living in the house and they're constantly interacting, but they're two separate components. And all of attachment systems and all of the stuff that they're connected with live in our neurobiology. We are the self-essence who is experiencing that reality and those activations, but we are not the attachment systems. We are consciousness. We are not the neurobiological projections of data. We are consciousness. We are the self-essence within the home of our brain and our body, having a life experience while interacting with that. So attachment systems, really important, super important. There's four primary attachment needs. And again, you can find out all about this in my book, Loving Liberation, a free gift from my heart to yours. we've got these four needs, and they're primarily feeling seen or loved, treasured, celebrated, appreciated, feeling safe, secure, protected, provided for, feeling connected, closeness, a sense of support, vulnerability, and collaborative community, and feeling accepted and recognized, and having a sense of directional guidance and permission. And so we've got these four primary attachment needs, and they create four attachment systems from which everything in our unconscious mind and body develop. Okay? So while we're moving through life experience, every single piece of stimulus is activating our attachment systems and everything else that it's connected to. If you walk down the street, the process of moving your feet and moving through orientation of time and space and seeing a tree is activating your attachment systems. Every piece of stimulus is activating our attachment systems. And when our attachment systems become activated, the status of their needs also becomes activated and projected into the experience of subconscious parts beyond direct and immediate awareness. So basically, we've got all these parts of our consciousness who are experiencing life without our direct knowledge. 95% of our consciousness are parts experiencing life without us having any understanding of what's going on. We're only aware of about 5% of our consciousness. And so we're up here and we're looking, we're like, okay, I see what that part of consciousness is doing. And I see what that part of consciousness is feeling. And then there's like a few hundred more parts that I can't quite get a glimpse of. That's kind of the reality of our internal self-sense. And so there's 95% of our consciousness experiencing life beyond what we know, beyond what we can directly perceive. And they are experiencing these nonstop projections of data from attachment systems regarding our attachment needs. And so if there was a feeling of not being seen and loved 20 years ago, subconscious parts are experiencing the projection of that reality nonstop with every piece of stimulus beyond our awareness. And they're feeling all those associated feelings without our knowing. And then maybe we get like this wave of like depression or loneliness. And we're like, I don't know where this is coming from. I was like totally doing fine. That's communication from parts of consciousness regarding their experiences in association with the neurobiological projections stemming from the unconscious mind and body, which are foundationally rooted in attachment systems, projecting the needs of attachment systems. Okay. Little bug. So while we move through life, our parts of consciousness are experiencing all the stuff that we don't know about. And it's important to keep this in mind. Because if we're moving through life and we're like, oh, I feel lonely. You don't feel lonely. A part of your consciousness beyond your direct awareness has been experiencing nonstop projections of data from an unfulfilled attachment system number one. And they are experiencing loneliness and they are asking you for help with your love. Because if you say, I feel lonely, you're blending your conscious awareness with your subconscious parts and forfeiting the opportunity to actually be there for yourself. Because loneliness cannot be cured by the outside. You cannot heal loneliness by being around other people. Loneliness is coming from an unfulfilled attachment need that only you can meet. Only you have the power to meet your attachment system needs. As long as they are being satisfied by an external source of stimulus, your attachment systems are not healing. And this is super important. Because if we're feeling lonely, we might go hang out with friends or something and be like, oh, I don't feel lonely anymore. But the loneliness is coming from an unfulfilled attachment need. And as until you meet that for you, it will remain unfulfilled and continue producing those chronic types of experiences. So being around friends doesn't cut it. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. If you need to be around people to just get yourself into a space where you can start to love yourself, do what you gotta do, of course. Take care of you. You deserve to be happy. But know that that's not gonna change what you're feeling. It might be a temporary fix, but then your attachment system, okay, so attachment systems you can think of as like a big ship. And they're moving through and they're constantly casting these lines with a hook and a magnet. And so you just picture like all of these parts of consciousness on this super epic boat that's sailing through the oceans of life. And they're just, the attachment systems are constantly casting out these lines and they hook into whatever fulfills the attachment system need. And then the magnet pulls the ship towards that. Okay? And then parts of consciousness are never free to be who they are or do what they want or feel how they want to feel because they're constantly experiencing the ship just gravitating towards these things that these magnets are stuck in. Okay? And so if you're like moving through and then you're like, you know, I'm lonely. I'm going to go hang out with friends. Then the attachment system, it talks about feeling seen and connected or whatever. This hook goes out. The hook goes into the external stimulus of being with friends. And then that hook is there. And in order for the attachment systems to continue surviving, they pull towards that. And so then you just need to be with friends more. You need to be with friends more. You need to be with friends more. You need to be with friends more. Because that's what you're focused on to fulfill your attachment need. And so until your attachment systems are fulfilled from within, you will always be subjected to the needing external stimulus for you to even have any kind of sense of well-being. And that's a pretty powerless place to be. If you need certain kinds of things to feel okay about who you are, or to feel safe, or to feel connected, or to feel directionally guided, or to feel loved and celebrated, then your entire inner being is suffering without you knowing it, because you're only aware of 5% of what's going on. And then you're like, oh, I'm doing fine. Oh, I got this like wave of loneliness. It's because it's been there the whole time, but it was being neglected. That loneliness has been experienced by subconscious parts long before you were aware of it in your awareness. When you experience a thought in your awareness, it has been brewing unconsciously for a long time, constantly experienced by parts of your inner experiencer. Your parts of consciousness have been experiencing loneliness that whole time, maybe for weeks or months or years before you feel it consciously and you're like, ooh, I'm feeling this like wave of loneliness. No, your parts of consciousness have been feeling that. And all that is a clue inviting you to heal your attachment systems. And so when you move through life, every piece of stimulus is activating your attachment systems. They're at the baseline of your subconscious realms. They are the modality that bridges your unconscious mind and body. They play this dramatic role in your entire inner being. We are nature and nurture colliding. Nature is this, you know, blueprint, this structure, this cellular structure about what a person generally is. And then all of the details of that are filled in through nurture. We are love-based beings in our consciousness and our neurobiology alike. And I have some really good news for you. There's only one kind of energy in the world, love. Anything that lacks love is just that. It's a space that's lacking love. There's no such thing as fear. There's no such thing as pain. There's no such thing as disease. And you're going to be like, wait, okay, I'm in pain right now, so you can't tell me this isn't real. I'm not saying the experience isn't real. The experience is extremely real. I'm talking the vibration of that thing is not real. Okay, let me back up. So there's heat and there's coldness. Am I right? Am I right? Are there these two things? And there's this thing called heat, and then there's this thing that's called coldness. And they're energetic frequencies creating these sensations. Is that correct? No! Surprise. Feel free to Google it. There's simply heat and a lack of heat that feels like coldness. There's not hot and cold. There's simply heat and a lack of heat. And that feels like coldness. It's the same thing with love. There is simply love and a lack of love, which can feel like pain, dis-ease, fear, loneliness, heartache, heartbreak, devastation, discouragement, somatic pain, anxiety, depression, traumatic stress, phobias, fears, helplessness, hopelessness, suicidality, phobias, OCD. It can feel like a lot of things, but there's no such thing as fear or pain or dis-ease. Those are just experiences stemming from an energetic space within your being that lacks love. That's what that is. There's only one kind of energy within personal experience. It is love and a lack of love. And a lack of love can feel like all of these things. But the same way that there's not heat and coldness, not hot and cold. There's just hot and a lack of hot. There's just heat and a lack of heat that feels like coldness. It's the same thing. There is love and there is a lack of love. And the lack of love can feel like pain, disease, loneliness, despair. But all it means is that it's a clue of consciousness of a space within your neurobiological applications of consciousness that need an energy of love so that it can thrive. And say that again. Those things, those experiences of pain, disease, fear, loneliness, depression, anxiety, traumatic stress, all of it, they're all just clues of consciousness indicating a space within your neurobiological applications of consciousness that require your love to experience healing. That's all any of that ever is. Because when you love yourself, you heal your attachment systems. When you heal your attachment systems, you reprogram your neurobiological states and reprogram all subconscious timelines that house your memory systems and meaning-making associations and the way you experience yourself and other people and the world and the way you perceive and the way you recall your life and the way you interpret experience and the way you project potentials of experience and the way you remember your past. All of that changes when your attachment systems heal, because they are the foundation of everything. And your attachment systems heal when you love yourself. As long as love or a sense of fulfillment is coming from outside of you, your attachment systems are hooked there and they're not healed. When your attachment system needs are fulfilled from within, they heal and everything else changes and your life experience transforms from the inside out. Okay. Okay. Okie dokie. Alrighty then. So while we move through this life experience, it's important to keep this in mind. Okay. So we're moving through and we're walking down the street. With every piece of stimulus, our attachment systems are being activated. And so if we see something and it startles us, what's happening is there's a piece of external stimulus, like maybe you see something scamper across the road and you don't know what it is, and so you feel a sense of startle. What's happening is there's a piece of external stimulus that's being transmitted through your unconscious states and then sent up to your attachment systems, boomeranging through all of these different aspects of personhood, which you can look at in my Pyramid of Personhood. You can download my free book at kristinwindsor.com/freebies. It's called Loving Liberation. You can look at the whole Pyramid of Personhood. It shows all the different aspects of personhood creating your life experience right here, right meow. And so there's this piece of external stimulus, right? You're walking, something startles you, and it goes through and it reaches that attachment systems, and your attachment system number 2 in the second region of your subconscious realms, according to my liberated consciousness diagram, revolves around a sense of safety, security, provision, and protection. And if that attachment system need is not met, then your nervous system becomes dysregulated. The dysregulation of your nervous system connects with your memory systems and projects information regarding your lack of safety in the world. And so you think you're just seeing something scamper across the road. No, your neurobiological applications of consciousness are digging through your entire life experience about how you're not safe. And that's being projected into your awareness. And then you experience your heart racing and jumping startle. And you're like, oh my God, I should never go for a walk again because this feels terrifying. And your brain makes a conclusion based on your experience, but your experience is only dependent on the data that's being activated inside of your neurobiology, which 100% stems from the satisfaction and fulfillment of your attachment needs. Pookie bear, stop it. And so keep this in mind while you're moving through your life. Your life experience is coming from inside of you. Every single thought and feeling are just being generated from the neurobiological activations of your subconscious realms, and they're all just clues about what your inner being needs. Your parts of consciousness are experiencing neurobiological activations, but they are not the neurobiological activations. Your parts are like, oh my God, I'm scared. But they're not the fear that's being projected. They're the space of the energetic space that is asking for love. Because parts are love. Subconscious parts are love. That's who they are. They are embodiers of love. They are givers of love. They are protectors of love. They are observers of love. Every single part of consciousness in our unconscious mind or our subconscious realm is a pure vibration of love. But they're experiencing projections from our neurobiology where there are all these spaces lacking love. And so it feels like fear. It feels like tension. It feels like anxiety. It feels like unworthiness. It feels like insecurity. It feels like I need to work and do and achieve and strive to be enough. It feels like I'm not safe, secure, provided for. It feels like I'm not free to express myself. It feels like dis-ease. It feels like anxiety. It feels like depression. It feels like traumatic stress. It feels like obsessive compulsions. I don't know if I conjugated that right. Words. It feels like all these things, but it's just a space in our neurobiology that's lacking love and being projected into our experiences of consciousness. But our parts of consciousness are not the projections. Our parts of consciousness are always a pure vibration of love. They just don't know it. So we got to help them see it by not blending with things, by staying grounded in the personal power space of our awareness, by staying grounded up here and creating space to be there for our parts of consciousness by choosing a conscious response to these projections of data from our neurobiology. Okay, so we're walking through life. So here's where I was actually going to start the video. This is what I actually came on here to say. When we're moving through life, 100% of any kind of social interaction, whether we're looking at ourselves in a mirror, whether we're seeing our housemate in passing, whether we're talking to someone on the phone, whether we're walking through a park and we see people in the distance, whether we're at a grocery store and we're surrounded by people that we're not interacting with, any kind of social interaction, even seeing people on a television or hearing the sound of someone's voices in music, any kind of interaction with another human being or with the human being that we are activates our attachment systems even stronger, which means that the status of our attachment needs is being vibrantly ignited from within, passionately ignited. And so if we have a sense of not feeling loved or seen or treasured or celebrated in our first attachment system, walking through the grocery store is going to activate that really, really strongly. And your parts of consciousness beyond your awareness will be experiencing hundreds, if not thousands, of projections from every moment in your life where you did not feel seen, loved, or celebrated. But the good news is that you do not ever need to look back to heal. If you love, appreciate, celebrate, and treasure who you are today, you will heal your attachment systems connected with data from your entire life. That's the beauty of this brain rewiring magic that I have discovered. You don't need to look back to do the majority, if not all, of the healing. You don't need to look at where the pain is. You just need to look at where your needs are at right now. You don't need to look at all the times you were dissatisfied and unfulfilled and having your needs met. All you need to do is look here and now and see what you need now. So maybe you get out of the grocery store and you've watched this video so you know that there's this activation in your attachment systems and you don't have a complete sense of fulfillment regarding feeling seen, loved, and celebrated from within. And so maybe you get to your car after going through this grocery shopping trip and you flip down the little mirror and your visor thing and you look yourself in the eye and you're like, I appreciate you for shopping. I treasure you for shopping. Thank you for walking through the store and being so brave and wise and intelligent and patient to just get the things that you need and move through the experience with such bold courage. I celebrate you just for being alive. Thank you for breathing. Thank you for existing. Thank you for being here. And then you drive home. Little things like that will change your life because you are rewiring your brain on the deepest level imaginable to transform 100% of the neurobiology that's existing and operating beyond your direct and immediate awareness when you show up for your attachment needs in everyday life. And again, if you want to know the specifics of the attachment needs, you can download my free Loving Liberation book, a gift from my heart to yours, sharing what I have discovered in my epic healing journey. I've created brand new diagrams explaining human consciousness from the inside out, and they provide just so much transcendent insight and just helpful tools, just so helpful to understand life and be able to have more power in our response to it. Every piece of stimulus, every moment of life is activating our attachment systems. When we are in any kind of intrapersonal, interpersonal engagement, we see ourselves in the mirror, when we see another person, when we hear someone's voice, when we're talking with someone, those attachment systems and their associated needs are being activated even stronger. And subconscious parts are experiencing those activations beyond awareness. So our mind might be here and I'm like, okay, I'm just driving and I'm doing my thing. We might not be aware that there's 100 parts of our consciousness feeling the most devastating, crushing feeling of loneliness because they're encountering automated projections from an unfulfilled attachment system and the needs that it carries. And then that continues, and then it dysregulates our nervous system when we wonder why we're feeling anxious and lonely. It all comes from unfulfilled attachment needs, but healing that can only come through our own love. As long as the love is coming from outside of us, as long as the sense of safety or connection or feeling seen or celebrated or guided or allowed is coming from outside of us, our neurobiology is still suffering. The love has to come from inside of us for it to be healing. There's only one kind of vibration in the world. There's love and there's the lack of love. And any space that's lacking love can be healed through our own love. And that can look like a million things. It's not about what you do, it's about the way it makes you feel. It's about you feeling your own love. And that can look like an infinite number of things. The opportunities are literally limitless. It matters about how it makes you feel, how it makes your inner experiencer feel. And then you heal your neurobiology from the inside out and transform your entire life experience as sensed through consciousness. In each moment of every day, your brain is already encountering rewiring. Watching this video has already rewired your brain. So choose wisely where you direct your focus. Because where you direct your energetic attention, where you direct your energetic focus, where you direct the energy of your consciousness is what grows inside of you, including in your brain's neural networks. And so if you're listening to a lot of music about this, like, you know, these sappy love song, romantic sagas, you're feeding your mind these ideas of a romantic connection. And then if you don't have that romantic connection, your neurobiological applications of consciousness are going to feel that space of lack, a space that is not fulfilled with love. Just as one of infinite examples. Nothing wrong with that kind of music, but what is it doing to your brain? How is it activating your neural networks? How is it activating your attachment systems? What if you listen to music that talked all about how you're perfect as you are and you deserve the world and the life is beautiful and you deserve to just be happy and just the sun shining is magic? And what if it was that instead of, he won't call me back? Again, just as one of infinite examples. It's about how things are making you feel. And if you're feeding your brain stimulus that is encouraging this sense of lack, this sense of unfulfillment, this sense of there's not enough love inside of me already, your parts of consciousness are going to be experiencing those neurobiological projections of data beyond your direct and immediate awareness. Every moment of your life is rewiring your brain. How you are experiencing your brain is dictated by the past experiences that wired your brain. You didn't have power then, potentially, okay? But now you have power. Now you know. You're here. You're with me. You're hanging out with me on my awesome channel, learning about rewiring your neurobiological applications of consciousness from the inside out, learning how to rewire your own brain. Like, what? Way too cool. Now you have power. Now you have power. With great power comes great responsibility. Now you have an opportunity to transform your future experience by rewiring your brain today. Because how you experience your brain a month, a year, 5 years from now directly depends on how you plant seeds of rewiring your brain today. Because your brain is always undergoing transformation. And if you don't consciously direct it, it's going to happen unconsciously and be subjected to experience, which there's no power there. There's no power in letting experience determine how your brain rewires itself. But you have power to choose how your brain undergoes reconstructive wiring. You already have that power. You already have that power. And if you want to get started, I have a brain rewiring playbook with my freebies, my gifts from my heart to yours, sharing the super indescribably complex magic in simplified ways from everything that I've discovered while I rewired my brain against all odds, against the greatest depths of impossibility. And so it's a nice, just simplified toolkit, and you can just start rewiring your brain in just a few simple, easy steps in your everyday experience. You don't even need to like go off and be like, okay, I'm having a 1 hour session of brain rewiring. No, it's something you can just like casually do in your everyday experiences. So please feel free to grab the brain rewiring playbook in the freebies, kristinwindsor.com/freebies. And while you're on my website, feel free to check out other magics. I have a bunch of self-guided healing journey programs, and you can learn more about me and my healing journey and what I do as a consciousness consultant. And then if you want to book a one-on-one session, you can schedule that at kristinwindsor.com. I would love to connect with you one-on-one and share sacred healing space to serve as a healing journey guide for you so that you have all of the tools, insight, clarity, resources, empowerment, guidance, everything needed to step into your power in new ways. And whether you're experiencing a mental or emotional or relational or spiritual or action patterned battle, or whether you just want to have more confidence or more something, anything, any part of your life experience coming from inside of you can be transformed when you rise into your power. And that's what I'm here to help with. So please feel free to book a one-on-one session with me at kristinwindsor.com. Attachment systems are being activated in every moment of every day. With every moment that they're activated, the status of their needs are also engaging. Your parts of consciousness beyond awareness are experiencing projections from that information. You heal your unconscious mind and body when you create sensationally felt, tangible experiences of love from within you to fulfill those attachment needs, reclaim all those hooks on that ship, take them away so that they're turned inward and you are hooked on your own inner being. Thank you so much for joining me for Conversations with Kristin. I believe in you infinitely. You are worthy of infinite moments of happily ever after. I truly believe you have enough power to embody happiness, not just pursue it. Healing is always gradual and never linear. It's an up and down journey with constant growth, but it only grows when we choose to invest in it through the power of our own energy. So please dare to invest in yourself because you are worth it. And you can download some Kickstarter stuff for free at kristinwindsor.com/freebies. Please take advantage of this. I want you to have the tools to succeed because you deserve it. And we're all just here journeying through life and rising into greater realms of love together. We're all in this together. We're all connected with the human consciousness and the human experience that we are, having different experiences, but we're all connected in this. We're all in this together. We're all just transforming ourselves into higher vibrations of love. That's what everyone in the world is doing, whether they realize it or not, whether they directly acknowledge it or not. That's what we're all here for. It's the evolutionary expansion of the human species, rising into greater vibrations of love, because only love is real. Only love is real. Anything that's not that is just a space lacking love. Have a beautiful and blessed day, soul friends. Thank you so much for joining me. And if you liked hanging out or you got anything from this video or you just appreciate me in any capacity, please feel free to hit that like and subscribe button. I appreciate your support on my channel. I'll see you next time, soul friends. I'm sending you lots of love, infinite light, and radical divine blessings. Namaste. Divine love and light in my miraculous consciousness. See and honor the divine love and light in your miraculous consciousness. Have a beautiful and blessed day, and I will see you next time, soul friends. Thank you for being here, and thank you for being you.